Hello everyone. Today, I want to guide you through different ways to fix and resolve Wi-Fi issues you may encounter with your laptop. Specifically, we will focus on situations where your laptop does not display a Wi-Fi connection or has a cross on the Wi-Fi icon, indicating that there is indeed a problem with your wireless connection. Let's start with the first cause of your Wi-Fi issues. Cause one, it's possible that you have accidentally turned off the Wi-Fi feature using a specific function key on your laptop's keyboard. To fix this, look for a key combination like FN plus, F2, F3, F4, F5, F12, etc. You will need to press the key with the Wi-Fi icon or image, which is often represented by a small illustration symbolizing a wireless connection. Next, consider cause 2. Another reason for sudden loss of Wi-Fi may be related to a physical on-off switch dedicated to Wi-Fi on your laptop. Some laptops have a separate switch located on the edge of the device, near the keyboard area. If your laptop has the switch, ensure that it is turned on, usually indicated by a blue light or a similar visual marker. Now, let's look at cause 3. You may have accidentally pressed a button or touch area that toggles the Wi-Fi on and off. This button is generally located right above the keyboard, close to where the laptop screen meets the body. Look for a Wi-Fi icon or a signal strength indicator and make sure to press it gently to turn the Wi-Fi back on. Cause 4, there may be a chance that you have configured the Wi-Fi to OFF within your laptop's network management settings. Plus, to troubleshoot this, click on the Wi-Fi icon typically found in the bottom right corner of your screen, and if possible, turn it on. Alternatively, you can right-click on the Wi-Fi icon, select Open Network and Internet Settings, find the Wi-Fi section in the Settings menu, and choose on to enable the Wi-Fi connection or off to disable it if needed. Cause 5, it might also be the case that you have disabled the Wi-Fi network adapter within the network settings on your laptop. Plus, if this is the issue, you will need to enable the Wi-Fi network adapter. Right-click on the Wi-Fi icon, select Open Network and Internet Settings, then navigate to Change Adapter Options. Here, locate the network adapter associated with the Wi-Fi function and enable it to restore internet access. Cause 6. In some cases, the problem might originate from the Wi-Fi driver being in conflict or even malfunctioning altogether. Plus, to address this issue, right-click on this PC, choose Manage, and quickly navigate to Device Manager. Once you're there, look for the category that says Network Adapters, click to expand it, and find the listing related to your Wi-Fi. After locating it, right-click on this entry and select the option Uninstall Device, ensuring you check the box that states Delete Driver Software for this device. Allow a moment for the old Wi-Fi driver to be completely uninstalled before you restart your computer and check if the laptop has regained its Wi-Fi connection. Cause 7. It could also be that your laptop is missing the necessary Wi-Fi driver entirely. Plus, the presence of a Wi-Fi driver is crucial for your laptop to connect to wireless networks. To rectify this issue efficiently, you can use a software called 3DP Chipnet, which can automatically take care of installing the required Wi-Fi driver. Search for 3DP Chipnet online to download this helpful utility and install it on your device. You might need to use an Ethernet cable to temporarily connect and access the internet, or alternatively, you can borrow another computer to download 3DP Chipnet and transfer it to your laptop through a USB drive. The installation process offered by 3DP Chipnet is generally quick and straightforward. Once the driver is installed successfully, you can then reactivate Wi-Fi and check for connectivity. Cause 8. It is also a possibility that the Wi-Fi function might have been disabled within your laptop's BIOS settings. Plus, some users accidentally disable Wi-Fi in the BIOS accidentally. But this is easy to check. You can enter your laptop's BIOS by pressing the correct function key during startup. Different laptop brands might require different keys such as F2, ESC, Delete, or F9. For instance, on a Dell laptop, you would turn on the device and repeatedly tap F2 until you enter the BIOS. Once there, navigate to the section that pertains to Wi-Fi and verify if the Wi-Fi function is listed as OFF or disabled. If you find it disabled, make sure to enable Wi-Fi within the BIOS settings. Cause 9. There may be additional underlying issues related to the BIOS settings themselves. Plus, it's important to note that some laptops can exhibit BIOS-related problems. If that's the case, returning to the BIOS settings as described before might help. While you are in the BIOS, an effective troubleshooting step is to load the default BIOS settings. Remember, before you load the default settings, it's prudent to make a note or record a video of your current BIOS configuration so that you have a reference to restore your custom settings should you need to revert back later. Cause 10. Lastly, the Wi-Fi network adapter itself could potentially be faulty, improperly seated, or even damaged. Plus, in numerous situations, the Wi-Fi adapter may be loose or covered in dust and dirt. In such instances, a good approach would be to carefully open up your laptop, remove the Wi-Fi adapter, and clean the contacts. After making sure it's clean, reinsert the adapter and power on your laptop to check if Wi-Fi connectivity is restored. You can also consider testing a Wi-Fi adapter from a different laptop, ideally one of the same brand and model, to see if it works better. Keep in mind, even adapters from different brands might be compatible and function correctly, though in some cases they might fit but not perform as expected. After you replace or clean the Wi-Fi adapter, turn on your laptop again and check to see if Wi-Fi connectivity is established. Lastly, if you are still facing issues with the laptop's Wi-Fi connectivity despite trying the steps mentioned above, a final efficient solution would be to purchase a USB Wi-Fi adapter. Plus, there are many kinds of USB Wi-Fi adapters available in various sizes, and they tend to be relatively affordable. All you need to do is to buy one, plug it into your laptop's USB port, and it should allow you to connect to Wi-Fi easily. This is a hassle-free solution that you can easily implement right at home. However, if your laptop still requires repair or further examination, don't hesitate to take it to a technician who specializes in laptop repairs. They can provide expert assistance or help you replace the Wi-Fi adapter effectively. Thank you for watching. I wish you success in resolving your laptop's Wi-Fi issues. If you found this helpful, please consider subscribing and liking the channel.